Wherever you are and wherever you find yourself on the journey of faith, you are most welcome here to receive the richness of God's love given for you. We all have at least a few of these. Some of them change across a lifetime. Some of them change as a family tree expands. Some of them stay the same from birth till death. We have so many names in one lifetime. Some of the names are simple and that they let other people know how to address us.
Mike.
Pat. Susan.
Some names come from our time in school.
Class clown. Slacker. Honor student.
Some names come even as we enter the workforce.
Accountant.
Teacher.
Some names change as the family tree expands.
Mother.
Grandfather. Godparent.
Some of our names are based on our hobbies.
Actor.
Football man. Drummer.
Some of our names we never asked for.
Refugee.
Widow. Sexual assault survivor.
Some names describe who we are at a given point in our life.
Addict.
Generous.
Some of our names other people assign to us in order to hurt us.
Fag.
Slut. Stupid.
Some of our names we assign ourselves.
Unworthy.
Failure. Disappointment.
We all have names, so many names. And by we, I mean every person with a heartbeat, no matter what country is home, no matter what skin color covers that beating heart, no matter what one can or cannot do. The world has its own set of names, its own set of rules that say those names are the full truth of who you are. And that is so much different than the truth about how God sees our names, or more accurately, how God sees our one name, the only name that ever matters. We as Christians are here this morning to tell the truth about names, and most of the world does not understand this, or does understand it and thinks that it's too good to be true, or it has to be some sort of scam, or wishes desperately that it could be true. Here as a gathered community, we hear a truth about God, this God who in the beginning made the earth out of the chaotic waters and called it good, this God who parted water so that the Israelites could escape oppression and travel somewhere where they could be safe and free, this God who inspired a prophet on the outskirts of town to use a river as his pulpit to talk about justice, repentance, and God's forgiveness, and who, with water swirling around his ankles, John the Baptist spoke about another one who was coming to stir us up, coming to save us all by loving us all. This God slipped in his skin and was born of a poor, unwed teenager, and one day, about 30 years later, took himself down to the river to pray. Kept walking as the water leapt up to his toes, to his waist, he went under the water and came back up. And at that same moment, a voice from heaven rang out with more beauty than even a sky full of angels who sang to shepherds in a field 30 years earlier to announce the birth of this child. God spoke words to the embodied word of God, I love you in your mind. And God has never stopped speaking those very words to God's children who gather at any living water. God continues over and over and over to speak the same words, praying that we will hear them, that we will hear this truth. You are loved and claimed as God's own. And all of this happens through plain, ordinary tap water and a promise in baptism. What happens in baptism is entirely 100% God's doing. And the truth of being loved, not because of what we do, means that this is the one relationship in your life that you cannot screw up. Precisely because you did not establish it. Now, we can neglect this relationship, we can deny it, run away from it, ignore it, but none of us can destroy it. For God loves us too deeply and too completely to ever let us go. This is the one relationship that can never be broken. In fact, trusting that this relationship is in God's hands, we are free to fly, as we read in the book. We are free to give ourselves wholly and completely to all the relationships in our lives. The ones with our family, our friends, those who are being treated unjustly, those in need in our community and halfway across the world. We are free to be open, to be honest, to be bold in our relationship, because we are loved, and love changes everything. When you know you are loved by God, fear doesn't win. When you know you are loved by God, there are obstacles, but they are not so scary because you know you do not face them alone. Knowing that our names are loved, and knowing the true name of every single person is also loved, that changes everything. The federal workers struggling without paychecks as the government continues the shutdown, their names are loved. The men, women, and children sitting in detention centers while their process is frozen in the shutdown, their names are loved. The elderly couple this week at Burger King who are living out of their car, their names are loved. The young man with anxiety and depression so deep he can't see light, his name is loved. The cranky person whose bad attitude gets under your skin and is battling demons you know nothing about, her name is loved. The addict who slips, his name is loved. The family across the globe that will receive the 3 cows and 4 goats that Living Waters raised enough money to buy in Advent, and the hundreds of families who are still waiting for a cow, their names are all loved. And you, dear ones of Living Waters this morning, your name is loved. And when, not if, you forget this God-given name, when grief is thick and it's hard to see anything, when this world does its best to confuse you, to make you forget, to tell you it decides what you're worth, either by grades or salary or numbers on a scale, when our culture does its best to convince you that your value is either in your relationship status or zip code or the job you do or do not have, when you can't remember who you are, come back to the water. Come back to this baptismal font, another church's font, a river, an ocean, the water in your own power. And be reminded that you have been baptized. And if you are not and you want to learn more about this, grab me after worship because this gift is for you too. God has declared, child, I love you and you are mine. And with this truth, we are sent into a world with that good news to share with others who are thirsty for that kind of living water. And there is enough for all of us to wade.